My name is George Harriman. I'm a systems architect here at ROHM Semiconductor, and my job is to help customers design in ROHM's broad portfolio of products, including those for EV chargers.
What do you consider one of the main EV challenges in the power sector?
Yeah, I think the main EV challenges, there are three. The first one would be the range of the vehicle. The best EV vehicle these days only get up to, for example, 350 miles. So going from San Francisco to LA, you will need to at least charge once in the middle. The time to recharge is also very long for EVs. It might take 20 to 90 minutes on a DC fast charger.
And what are the current trends in DC charging stations?
As EV batteries become bigger and bigger, because they need to go longer and longer distances, this means that the battery capacity becomes larger. Therefore, the EV charging station trend is we need shorter charging time. This leads into the fact that higher power charging is needed, and therefore wide band gap semiconductors such as silicon carbide devices may be needed to achieve high efficiency solution.
We understand the trend toward lower power consumption, but at the same time, the output voltage from batteries and generators can vary widely, and a versatile power supply solution is needed. How does ROHM answer the need?
The EV battery voltage ranges are currently, for example, for hybrid EV, it's 200 volts to 250 volts. Plug-in EV, it's 200 to 500 volts, while for a battery EV, it's 400 to 800 volts. ROHM has products both in automotive grade and also in industrial grade, such as IGBTs, silicon carbide MOSFETs, silicon carbide Schottky barrier diodes, and also bare die silicon carbide MOSFETs.
Why have silicon carbide MOSFETs become increasingly popular versus silicon MOSFETs and IGBTs?
As wide bandgap semiconductors, such as silicon carbide, provides 10 times the dielectric breakdown compared to regular silicon devices, this allows higher voltage in a smaller footprint.
How do silicon carbide devices play a role in the solution?
As silicon carbide devices exhibit much lower switching losses compared to IGBT and silicon power devices, silicon carbide devices may be found in such solutions such as onboard chargers, which is inside the car itself, offboard charging stations or EV chargers, and traction inverters, or sometimes called the main inverters.
What are the key areas engineers should pay attention to in regards to power and automotive electronics moving forward?
There are some key areas that needs to be paid attention to. The first one would be reliability. Secondly, safety. Third, new packaging.
Thank you, George, for answering the top questions about EV power. To learn more, visit Mouser Electronics' website.